Good morning, children. Today you are going to learn a new chapter, that is chapter number 13, light. Okay. What is light? Light, it is a form of energy which help us to see the things. Okay. Enable the things to see, right? And so many scientists, so many people analyzed about this, that what is mean by light and how it travels. On that basis, they saw that how the sunlight, right? Sunlight, the coming in between through the trees, in between the trees, how it reaches. And then we can say that if you are sitting inside a cinema hall, from there, from the projector, how the beam of light falls through the screen. And these such things they noticed and afterwards analyzed that the light travels straight. Because of this light only that shadows are forming. Okay. And for that property, okay, the property of traveling or the light in a straight line is known as rectilinear propagation. What it is? Rectilinear propagation of light. So understood, rectilinear means coming straight, moving straight. The light travels through straight. For this, there is an activity that you can say that how the light travels in straight line. Okay, for that, actually what you have to take three cardboard of the same size. Okay, for example, this one, if it is a cardboard, okay, one cardboard, then another cardboard, same, and then one more cardboard, okay. And all these three cardboards, this is cardboard number 1A, B, C, okay. And it all these three cardboards having the same size and keep in a same at a same distance, okay. Then keep here, then make one small hole in between each of these cardboards, okay. Then afterwards, here the same hole here, na, just opposite to that, keep a candle. Okay, so here I am keeping the candle. And the candle's flame should be here, okay, so that it will move through this hole. Keep in that way, adjust in that way, okay. This is the candle. I now light the candle, okay. Then it will light up. Then afterwards, through these three holes, you can see, okay. Eyes. That means through this we have to see. And if we are seeing through these holes, the light, you can see through this holes. That means it is moving on the straight line. Understood? That this moving in a straight line only. The flame, if you are able to see through these three holes, then it means we can see that the light is there, traveling in a straight line. If any one of this cardboard you disturbed or you changed its position, moved, shift here and there, then what happens? Suppose if you shift this one, what happens? Its hole will be coming down or maybe up. Then what happens? You cannot see the image, this light, right? Because it will disturb, it will obstruct there. The light will obstructed there. So you can't see the light. It means from this activity, what we can say that the light travels in a straight line. Okay, so that is only rectilinear propagation of light. Okay, And we can see this rectilinear propagation of the light where are all the places it occurs. See this formation of the shadow. How it happens? The shadows. Shadows, if it is the light or the sunlight coming, okay? Sunlight. Or then if you are standing here, okay, a person is standing here, then if the light coming directly here, that means the light is straight moving. And if this person is standing here, so he is obstructing this light. If he was not there, then what happens? The light is trying to fall on the ground or somewhere else. But this person came in between so that he is obstructing. So what happens? His image will form here. Okay. So his image form on this place. That means the shadow. That image we cannot say shadow. Okay. Shadow. His shadow will be formed on this place. That also be the same way. Right. And see why this shadow is formed? Because of the straight line of this light, and this light is obstructed by the opaque body. Because this body is opaque, it will not allow the light to pass through. That's what. Okay. And that is one. That is the formation of shadow. And the second one, if you are saying, that is, we can say the day and night. Okay. Day and night, it is also formed due to the rectilinear propagation of the light. Then you may ask how it will be. Because see, this is our earth, right? And the earth rotates, right? That time, see, when this light fall, sun rays falling from here, okay? Sun's rays fall on this side, that time, this side becomes a day, right? At the same time, this side what it will be? That will be the shadow of it only. That means here the night. So that is also because of the rectilinear. Whether it is slanting, if it is slanting also, it is coming straight only, right? So that day and night also formed due to the rectilinear propagation of the light. And the third one, if we are saying, that is that pinhole camera, okay? Pinhole camera, there also it is formed due to the rectilinear propagation of the light. This pinhole camera I will explain in detail for your activity also, this pinhole camera only. Okay, how to make a pinhole camera. For this pinhole camera, here that means it is like a camera only, but through the pinhole it occurs. That's what its name, pinhole camera. For this you can also make at your home, take a cardboard, okay, like this, take a cardboard, okay, and this cardboard, sir, one side should be open, okay, cardboard, right, and it's one side open, okay, and the another side it should be closed. This open side, you have to cover it with a trace paper. Okay? What? With a trace paper. Just cover it this place. Okay? So, it acts as what? It will act as a screen. Understood? And then just opposite to this screen, this side. Here, you have to make a small hole. Okay? This much big, no? Small hole you have to make. That will be the act as a pinhole. Okay, with a pin itself, you can make a small hole over there. Sometimes if you want, you can keep this area covered with black paper. Then afterwards, again, with the pin, you have to make a small hole over there. Okay, so that it acts as a pinhole. Then, what you have to keep? Just to keep it this side outside. Okay, this side, keep it. That means if you want it to focus a tree. Or if you wanted to keep a candle, if I am keeping, just I am keeping a candle here, okay, a candle here, lighted candle, okay, then what happens, this light, then if you are keeping, just focusing on this camera, candle, and keep inside a dark room, so that the light comes here, then you can see through this hole, if you are seeing, this light, it comes like this now, like this, right? So, here you will get the image of this candle. But it will be inverted. inverted means upside down. Okay, upside down you will get it. That only what it is a small, it will get, you will get the small image there, and it will be very that means upside down, that is inverted image that will be you will get. Okay, so that is on the screen. Understood? This is only pinhole camera. So that image getting through this pinhole, so it is a pinhole camera. Okay, you have to, you can try this at your home. Okay children, so this pinhole camera, that also works on the basis of what is its principle of pinhole camera, that its principle is rectilinear propagation of light. That means the light travels in a straight line. Understood this one? Now I will explain about the ray. What is mean by ray, and then what is mean by beam. Okay, ray means if a straight line moving with an arrowhead, this is an arrowhead. Okay, it is an arrowhead, then we call it as ray. This arrow, what it shows, it shows the direction. Okay, in this direction it, this light is moving, this ray is moving, so this shows, the arrowhead shows the direction. Okay, and if the number of rays passes, okay, the number of ray pass, then what we will call it as, that is known as beam. That means a group of ray moving together, then it is known as beam. And if it is a single line, straight line with an arrowhead, then it is known as ray. Okay, now see the different things also. See, if the number of rays moving from a source, okay, this is the source of light. Source means from where the light gets, okay, whether it is an artificial source or it is a natural source. Okay, so this, if this light falling coming from one point to different directions, moving in different directions, see these arrows, so it may be coming in this way or in all directions it can move. Okay, that is known as what? Divergent. What it is? Divergent beam. Okay, divergent beam of light. So which example? So it means from one point itself in different directions the rays moves, so that is divergent beam. Okay, so example which we can give, sunlight. Sunlight coming from sun, okay, that is the divergent beam example, because the, from the sun in different, all the different places the rays moves, so that is a divergent beam. If the number of rays are coming from different directions and towards a point, okay, meet at a point from different directions, the rays meet at a point, then that is known as convergent beam of light. Okay, convergent beam. For example, this one, what we can give, because from different directions the light coming towards a point, so here example we can say our own eyes. Okay, human eye, human eye you can give, because the light from different directions fall on our retina and then the image forming, so that is an example for human eye. Understood? Here, and still cameras from there also, that getting, that is also be from different directions only light reaches the, this place. Understood? Convergent and divergent. Divergent means the from one point the ray, the number of rays fall in different directions, but here from different directions the number of rays meet at their place, so that is convergent. Clear? Now I will explain the next one, that is this that is reflection. Okay, so what it is, that is the reflection. So here if we are saying reflection, the next topic, when a light fall on a surface. Okay, the light fall on the surface. Either it will be absorbed, or it will be it allowed to pass through, or it will be bounced back. Okay, that only this reflection. Okay, so here for example, if a light fall on a mirror, you can say that is the smooth surface, right? This is the mirror. Okay, when a ray of light hit on this object, meet on this object, mirror, then that ray is known as incident ray. What it is? Incident ray, because it hit the mirror. Okay, hit, if a ray hit an object, then that is known as incident ray. And after hitting, what will be happen? It will be reflected back, that means bounce back or going back, then that is known as a reflected ray. Okay, understood? Incident ray and reflected ray. In between, there will be a normal ray. This is the normal ray. Okay, so here there is actually law of reflection is there. What it is? Laws of reflection. There are actually three laws. Okay, how many laws? Three laws. First law says that this incident ray, this is the incident ray, right? That here when it forms, there will be an angle forms. Okay, this is angle I. Okay, and here also an angle form, that is angle R. We can say R. Okay, this angle I, that is the incident. Okay, so here what is the law or laws of reflection? First law, what it says that the distance, that means from this angle forming from this incident ray and the normal ray. This is the normal ray, right? So incident to normal, that is equal to the reflected ray, the angle of reflection and the normal ray. Normal, okay? So angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection. That is only first law. Okay, and then second law, what it says, this angle of incident, angle of reflection and this normal, these three lies in a straight. Okay, that means incident ray and reflected ray and the normal ray, normal, all lies on the same plane. In the same plane. That is the second law. And the third law, what it says, that is this angle of incident, this incidence, no, that's a distance. This always angle of incident and angle of reflected, both of them always coming in different directions of this normal ray. Okay, it will be on different places. It never comes like this. If it is a normal ray, okay, normal ray, and it never comes like this. This is the incident ray, and then the reflected ray also coming here. It is actually wrong because it is in left side only, right? If this incident ray comes on the left side of this normal ray, then it should be, the reflected ray should be on the right side. That only say, okay. So it is wrong, and then how it should, it should come in this way. So it is the normal rays left and right, both on different places only it should come. That is the third ray, third law of reflection. Understood? Law of reflection. Now this mirror, okay, this mirror, it is actually made of the glass, right? Mirror, it is a smooth surface. So the smooth surface, if it is coming, then the rays, reflected ray, it will be going in, that will be in smooth, from smooth as well as two will be coming, right? One is the regular and another will be the irregular. If it is falling on the smooth surface, then the reflected ray goes, it will be, that is the regular ray. And if it is falling on the irregular spaces, irregular space, that is, it is the smooth. If it is irregular means it is like this. If it is on this rough smooth, rough place, okay, this is the rough place, if the light fall, then there will be a irregular image get, that if reflection will be of irregular. Understood? That only reflection. And this mirror, it is a smooth one, and not only that, its one side will be coated coated with the silver, or with the we can say that amalgam. Amalgam, actually it is the thing that is a metal, if we dissolve in mercury, then we will get that amalgam. That actually helps to reflect this rays. Understood? I hope you all understood this one. So in the next class, I will explain about the different images. What are the different images we get? Okay. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.